other that I've learned and that I've witnessed. Which is to follow creeks and other bodies of water and to get into thick areas, possibly pine thickets, places that are close to residential areas, but about as far away as you can stay and still be close at the same time. Really good natural hiding spot. From what I remember, there's an even better one down here. This is a really good hiding spot. I could travel this creek. And no one would ever know. Check that out on the way out. See if there's hair anywhere. You'd probably find the hair of about 400,000 different animals, but it's been a while, but I think this was the hiding spot I was looking for. bunch of these little hidey holes out here. Makes you wonder. This phone is the only light I have to get back with. I'm not far though. I'm only about a quarter of a mile from the house. Maybe a little more than that, maybe half a mile. But see, I would love to come hang out somewhere like this at night. That way. They wouldn't be able to hear me, but it also means I can't hear them. And I do believe why a lot of these sightings happen along creeks and rivers is because of the noise from the water. That creeks and rivers have their own thermal areas. Who knows? It's about to get real spooky back here though. Rock outcropping. Real quick before I head back. You're not gonna be able to see anything really. But my hope is that as it gets darker, let's go up there. something lives in there.